that's every threat, my boy. Toll free.
Toll free.
That's direct, my boy. And if you need a couple, I'm gonna connect, my boy, off the top.
I just scraped it off the top.
The third and final week of the preseason is here. A fourth exhibition game is a thing of the past. It's the Lions and the Steelers coming up next.
But not far from where the Steelers' former homes at Three Rivers Stadium, Forbes Field once stood, we are at Pittsburgh's Acrisure Stadium.
Today, it's week three of the preseason, and we've got a good one in store between the Detroit Lions and the Pittsburgh Steelers. Brandon Gaudin and Charles Davis with you, and now we sit, CD, at week three of the preseason, and this is the one that the coaches probably think is pretty valuable, right?
Certainly. This is the dress rehearsal. This is the one where your starters are going to play. You might even game plan a little bit more than you do with a normal preseason game. And then you've got to decide, do you bring them back after halftime and get them going again in the third quarter so they're ready to go when the regular season begins? I'm eager to see how these coaches will handle that.
So the Steelers offense getting set for their first drive. To throw is Harris on first and 10. Pass complete. George Pickens with it. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. 17 yards on the game's opening play and a quick first down. Looking to throw. Harris being chased out left. He'll get 3 yards on the scramble there and second down. Off the play fake. Harris. And under the Lions' pressure, he's brought down. Tall task ahead of him here, needing a full 15 yards to move the chains. And he'll take this to the 47, but no further as they get him. So Pittsburgh retakes the field for their second offensive possession. A last series form, a little disappointing, forced to punt. And now they'll try to do better here and come away with some points as they begin this drive, first and 10. And he'll wind up losing yardage here, back at the 21-yard line. Now Harris, off the play fake. It's Miller, complete. And they work this well upfield across the 45. A first down there on a pickup of 25. Off play action. Harris. And he can't find a receiver, and he's brought down. Protection certainly going to need to be a bit better here on second and 16. The throw over the middle taken in. And they'll get this down to around the 47-yard line. For the Lions, an extra DB in the game now here on third down. Operating from the gun, Harris. 5 yards on the scramble, and that's enough to pick up the first.
How many times do we hear that third down may be the most important down in football, and there's no better example than what we just saw right there. Forced to scramble, knows where the first down marker is, dives for it, and gets it. What a big-time play, putting his body on the line to pick up a key first down.
The passing game in rhythm right now for Pittsburgh. There's another first down.
Good work there on that completion. You know, once we made the move, Charles, from four preseason games down to three, kind of tougher to know how to handle these games as a coaching staff. And they've decided they wanted at least some of their starters out there. They said probably for this entire first half. Do you agree with that?
Ordinarily, Brandon, I wouldn't, but I actually do, and here's why. When we went from 4-3 in terms of preseason games, we left a bigger gap between the third game and the start of the regular season. So there's a lot of time for rust to build up, right? And some bad habits to...
Second quarter action from Pittsburgh. It is the Steelers in control of the football as they've got it with a third down coming up. Back to throw. Harris completes this one to Pickens. And it's going to be another first down as they'll get him to the ground at the Lions 21. Give him 10 yards there as this offense is on a roll. This drive continues to plunge forward. Here's Harris throwing on first down. And just not enough on the throw there. Down around his feet and incomplete.
Well, a momentary speed bump there with that throw, partner. The defense had other ideas, and they're trying to mount a small stand before this drive reaches the end zone.
They try to throw on second down, but this one is incomplete. Well, this drive, they're perfect 2 of 2 on third down conversions, but they need a full 10 yards here. A throw there, but that's going to wind up incomplete.
Well, how about the coverage we just saw break out on third down? Dive deep.
A reminder, opening weekend definitely in sight now, Thursday, September 8th.
They go play action here on first down. That one tipped and it's incomplete. What good hands there defensively at second down. He'll try again with the arm here on second down. And this time he's got the hookup. It's complete. And they're going to move it down to inside the 25.
And I know this is a quarterback who's looking forward to week one. He's going to get a chance here, barring injury, to be their starter and to go into a season in the number one spot for the first time in his career. But he's put the work in over his first 4 years in the league, and he feels like this is his time.
Back to throw again.
And that'll be off the mark, too far out in front, and it's incomplete.
This offense so far on third down, they've hit 2 for 4 thus far. Here it's 3rd and 2.
Able to find his man, it's Pickens. And the Steelers are going to have 1st and goal coming up as they're able to convert there on 3rd and 2. Snell, oh, he's going absolutely nowhere as he is hit behind the line.
Harris to throw on 2nd down. Touchdown! Deontay Johnson, a 5-yard touchdown, and the Steelers are going to take the lead.
Their quarterback leading this offense back out. He had the touchdown.
Off the play fake, Harris. Toward the sideline, and look at that catch. Dragging the toes, and that's going to be a 1st down. Well done. 18 yards the gain for number 18. One play has him up past the 40 already, and another 1st and 10. Looking to throw. Harris. He's got this to Pickens. He's got room at the 30. And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. Another big play here as they strike for 31. So now then, the big play has him all the way inside the... And he's going to go down. They sack him back right around a 30. Carlos Dunlap. That is now 2 sacks for him here in this first half.
So, Charles, no turnovers yet for this offense, but those sacks now, they're starting to pile up.
And one thing usually leads to another because they've got to figure out how the offensive line and everyone else involved in protection can keep their quarterback upright and allow him a chance to throw the ball downfield.
Sacks, a growing theme in this first half. This is 2nd and long. Steps away to his left. And he's just going to get rid of this thing to no one here. He throws it away, and now it's 3rd. Now on 3rd and long, they'll look to throw.
And he will be very close to a 1st down, but I see the closed fist of the referee, and that means 4th down.
time for the Steelers offense now to get set for their first possession of half number two.
And their three-point halftime lead gone now, back to a tie game. But, Charles, I don't imagine that changes too much for this offense.
I would agree. I don't think it changes much at all, whether it's a three-point lead or a tie game. They know they have their work cut out for them, and they were going to run their offense in the same vein.
Call that a very strong gain of 24. Operating from the gun, Harris. He finds his man, Johnson. And they'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20. So the big play means just like that, they'll operate from the red zone now on first down. And he can't get rid of it. He's taken down. They're going to hurry back to the line now. Harris now looking to throw on second down. And his throw's going to be incomplete. An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. Off play action, Harris. And that will be incomplete. Oh, he left that one in a bad spot, but fortunately it's just an incompletion and not picked to bring up fourth down. And Pittsburgh getting set to take the field. And last time able to get three. It's not what they wanted. They wanted six.
Let's go now. 60 bucks.
To throw is Harris. Throwing to start the drive. And he can't find anywhere to go with it. And he goes down. Ndamukong Suh with a sack. We've seen that a ton since he entered the league in 2010. Now Harris to throw on second down. Crossing route, catch made by Johnson. And they're going to get this beyond the 40 before he's taken down. Now a timeout called for by the offense. It's just their first, so two remaining as they burn one here in this third quarter. Here's a ball thrown. And now look at this. Big gain, but a fumble. And this is scooped up by the Lions. And they are going to set up shop at the 40-yard line. And looky there, Charles, just acquired, already making an impact on the defensive side of the football.
Maybe not a superstar, but he does a few things well, and I think they'll emphasize that in his new role with this team.
Charles, and this is a game that certainly had some intrigue, but I think you and I both agree. We like the decision to not play overtime in preseason and just call it a draw.
Partner, I want to meet the person who disagrees with this decision, and I just wonder what took so long for the league to arrive at this conclusion. They put the rule in for the 2021 season, and it should have been in a long time ago. Yeah, some rookies might miss some plays, but all in all, no one's paying attention when we get to the end of a preseason game.